I started cooking when I was living at home with my parents, and that kind of just involved cooking dinner for my younger brothers and sister whilst they were working full time. Making spaghetti bolognese and messing around with all the spices in the cupboards, and one day I just remember like putting chilli in the spaghetti bolognese and my mum was like, I can't eat it, I'm sorry, and I was so upset about it. So I wanted to try and like kind of prove her that I could actually cook. And then I kind of went to school and I did the GCSE cooking course. Then I went to catering college and did 2 years there. Decided I really enjoyed it. Then I decided to take it up full time at One Rosette Hotel. And that was just based in Luton, my hometown. I went to eat at Adam's restaurant in Birmingham and I loved the food so much, and I just saw so much like inspiration from the dishes, and it just made me kind of want to cook that food. The feeling of when I ate that food, it was like, imagine if I could cook this food and if I could give this experience to somebody else. That's what kind of got me into it. The whole experience of from beginning to end has been really, really important to where I am now. Today I'm making a rack of lamb dish with salsify. So I'm doing salsify three ways. To cook the lamb, firstly, it's been French trimmed, so you can actually get this done by your butcher if you don't have time to do it at home. French trim, basically they clean the bones up and take off the excess fat off the top. And then all I've done is I've scored it. So this just helps with the cooking process. So when I render it down in the pan, it then kind of brings out the fat, crisps up the skin, and it just caramelises and makes it really, really tasty. Just season with a little bit of salt and a little bit of smoked pepper. Smoked pepper, and just kind of bring out that smokiness to it. And I don't want smoked lamb. All I want is just a tiny, tiny hint of smokiness, just the skin. And then I've just added a little bit of butter, thyme and garlic. That flavour of brown butter, thyme and garlic, it works so well. And it's just like a classic cooking technique, really. And then it goes into the oven. What I usually do is I put it in for 5 minutes and then test it, probe it. If you feel that it needs to go back in longer, you can put it back into the oven again. But once it's ready, I usually rest it for the same amount of time that I've cooked it for. So it comes out of the oven and onto a resting rack. On this dish, we've got the three types of salsify. We've got hen of the wood mushrooms, which brings it like a meaty, citrusy flavour. Once you add that lemon juice into the end, it just like gives you a wow factor when you eat it with the meat. We've also got a chive and pea dressing. So all I've done for that is pod some peas. I've lightly blanched them in some water with some butter and salt, really, really gently, and straight into ice water. After that, I've kind of dressed them with the chive oil that I've made and a tiny bit of sea salt, mix them together, and that just dresses the plate really nicely. We have a lamb sauce on there, which is really, really thick, really full in flavour, using the roasted lamb bones, which enhances the lamb flavour even more into the sauce. Using fennel as well in that sauce kind of brings out the aniseed side to it. We also have on the dish a rainbow chard, so just one little piece of that which sits nicely on underneath the lamb. And we have some sorrel flowers on there, which gives it a little burst of citrus on the plate, and some borage cress, which actually brings a little bit of freshness to the plate because it's got like a natural kind of saltiness to it. It's really, really nice, and it kind of refreshes everything that you're eating on the plate. The number one tip that I would give anyone making a rack of lamb dish would be try not to overcomplicate it, because lamb is such a lovely flavour on its own. It doesn't need too much